Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. So today in this video I'll be sharing you one of the important interview question by taking the real-time example of my project. So explain about the factory design pattern. So how to answer this? So basically, factory design pattern is one of the most used design patterns in Java, as most of you know. This is a creational design pattern actually, so which provides one of the best ways of creating an object. So in factory design pattern, what we actually do is we hide the logic of creating the object to the client, and by using a common interface we create the objects. So this is a basic definition, you can say. So now let me take an example, real-time example, and explain. So basically in my project there were customers. So I have taken employee as a name. So for in the customer class, there used to be one field called mode of contact, how the customer wanted to get contacted, through email or mobile number. So that will be contained in this, like email or mobile phone number. So based on the mode of contact, the process would happen. So now let me quickly create, okay, I already created, okay, let me quickly create one interface. Let me name what to name communication. Okay, so in this method we will be having one method, public void process, which takes employee class reference EMP. Okay, Control Shift O. Okay, so now we need two classes which implement this communication. So if we take class, one is what type? One is email communication. Okay, so in the okay, it implements communication. Okay, we need to override the method now. Let us take add an implement method. Just I'll be adding one sysout here. The actual logic used to go here, like how do we send an email to the employee. So let me add one sysout by saying employee dot get name employee dot get name communicated via email. What is the email? Employee dot get email. Okay, this is done. Save this. I will create one more class, mobile communication. Okay, mobile communication. Okay, I'll directly add here interface communication. It will add. Okay, so in this method I'll add one more sysout. So most basically this would be the sysout. Copy and paste, communicated via mobile employee dot get mobile number, sorry, what is that, phone number. Okay, save this. So these are the two classes which implement communication interface, and based on the employee mode of communication, the objects will get created. Now let us create a factory class. Let us name that communication factory. Finish. So inside this we can have our logic, like one method, public what it is returning, communication, get process. It will take a string as an input, mode of communication, let us name it as like that. So here goes our actual logic. If the email dot equals ignore mode of communication, then I'll be returning new email. What happened? What was the class? Email communication only, right? Yeah, got it. Else if it is mobile, mobile dot equals ignore, then I'll be returning new mobile communication. Yeah, else. So the sorry, and the default condition should be there, so return null. So now let us test this design, factory design pattern. So I've already created a employee list. So I have created 5 employees. One is Angel Priya. Mode of communication is email, and email ID is angelpriya@fb.com. Second employee is Thakur. Mode of communication is mobile. Email ID is thakur@shole, and mobile number is 74. Some random number I have given. Third is Papa Ki Pari, whose mode of communication is mobile, and papakipari@insta.com. Employee 4 is Gabbar Singh, whose mode of communication is mobile, and 50,000 is the mobile number. Just randomly I gave some number. Employee 5 is Ramu Kaka, who needs to be communicated to email, and ID is ramukaka@garden.com. So now we got an employee list. Now what we can do, I'm using for each here. Okay, employee emp colon employee list. Okay, now I need to catch this processor. So communication processor. So I'll firstly getting the processor, but how I'll be getting? I'll be creating the object of factory class communication factory. Factory equals new communication factory. So using this factory reference dot get process employee dot get mode of contact. So now based on the mode of contact, I'll be getting the processor. Now using this processor dot process, I'll process the employee. So now let us see. So basically what should print? Angel Priya communicated via email, and this email ID Thakur got communicated via mobile, mobile number. Similarly, Papa Ki Pari and Gabbar Singh Ramuka. So now let me run this Java application. So yeah, as you can see, Angel Priya got communicated via mobile, and sorry, via email. The email ID is this. Thakur got communicated via mobile, mobile number got printed. Gabbar communicated via mobile, mobile number got printed. Papa Ki Pari got communicated via email. Ramu Kaka got communicated via email. So So the same thing we can do using for each as well. Yeah, I know most of us might have commented by this time. For each, kya bare employee EMP. Sorry, there is a factory. Directly, I can use this client is factory dot get processor dot employee dot get mode. What happened? Employee dot get dot sorry process of employee. So in one line we can finish this off. So let me print some this out. Using Java 8 for each. Yeah, just this is all to print one empty line. So now let us see whether we are getting the same input. Yeah, the same thing happened. So this is the simple example that we can give to demonstrate a factory design pattern. So most of us, like I took my real-time experience, real-time scenario where we have used this. So if you don't have any what I can say readily available answer, you can take this example and you can demonstrate it. Just fake it, saying that we have a requirement based on which a customer has to be communicated via mobile number or email ID. So based on the mode of contact, we have like there is a scenario based on the mode of contact, the employee needs to be contacted. So in that scenario, we have used factory design pattern, and you can demonstrate this example. So most of my interviews I do this, so thought it would be definitely helpful for many. So this is a real-time scenario, and that's it for this video. So one request, if you want to contribute us something, you can always if at all you are buying something on Amazon, you can open any of our videos, and you people already
Writing's
know that,
not that.
We have using Amazon affiliation, so you can open the link below any video, and if at all you are buying something, you can search here directly, and you will so like basically we may get some what I say like some commission on this. So if you haven't subscribed is our channel, I would request you to please do subscribe our channel.
Hello.
You can already see the list of videos that we have already shared, and this might and there are few which are already there in the queue. So please do subscribe to catch all the latest updates, and thank you for watching. I hope this video might have helped at least few people. And one more thing, if at all you want to reach us out, you can always reach us out at this email ID for any questions or any help. You can always reach us out on this email ID which is there in the about section, or mostly under every video it will be given. So you can share even your interview experiences with us, so that we post it on our channel, and the what I can say the higher portion of the audience the video can be reached. And thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.